A Chicago teenager arrested, picked up by the FBI before he could board a plane for the Middle East to join the terror group. ABC's Chief Justice Correspondent Pierre Thomas has the latest from Washington. Good morning, Pierre.
Good morning, George. It's becoming a pattern. Another U.S. citizen accused of trying to get to Syria to join those ISIS killers.
The FBI says this 19-year-old from a small suburb of Chicago was trying to join ISIS at the very moment the radicals were threatening to execute fellow American Peter Kasich. The family of Mohammed Hamza Khan was in tears as they left federal court in Chicago Monday. Khan had just been charged with providing support to terrorists. He was arrested Saturday night at O'Hare Airport, trying to board a plane for Austria with a connecting flight to Turkey. From there, he was to be smuggled into Syria to join ISIS. Finding homegrown radicals is a top priority for the FBI. The extremists can be people supporting jihadists overseas or those plotting right here at home.
And as the Boston bombings illustrate, we face a continuing threat from homegrown extremists. Some call these people lone wolves, but I think that gives them too much dignity. It's a term I resist. I think of them as lone rats.
The allegations in the Khan case make it clear that ISIS is using the internet to effectively recruit inside the U.S. According to the charges against him, Khan allegedly met online an overseas operative who was trying to get him to Syria. Authorities say when they searched his home, they found a three-page letter laying out his hatred. He wrote, "Western societies are getting more immoral day by day, producing what he called filth."
The FBI says more than 100 Americans have gone or tried to go to Syria. The government is cracking down. If convicted, this young man faces up to 15 years in prison.